All right. So we are in the middle of the season and the NFL trade deadline has passed. We are officially in the second half of the season. So far, there are many teams in the NFL that have really shocked me with how disappointing or surprising they have been throughout this season. And by the way, there are going to be two NFL videos. One, this disappointing video that I'm bringing to you all today, and a surprising video next time. For this biggest disappointments video, I'm including players and teams in my list who simply did not meet expectations, let alone do the exact opposite. That being said, we are going to discuss the five biggest disappointments so far this NFL season. Amen, say man. This is the A-Man Show, back at it again for more content. Make sure y'all subscribe, I post NBA and NFL content, turn on post notifications so that way y'all stay tuned for more videos I put out. Anyways, stay tuned, and cue the intro.
Yo, Nick, pass, make it slap. I've been on the road, I'm gone. Private jet for me and I'm brosy. H. Lorenzo, pick up clothes. I made a fence and hit my hose up. Down on what I'm on, I'm on one.
Alright, so first and foremost, we have to talk about the Green Bay Packers with a 4-6 record going into the season. The Packers have been a big disappointment so far. Despite Aaron Rodgers' great game against the Dallas Cowboys, he has taken a step back in his play. He hasn't been making the throws that he usually makes, and overall, he hasn't been the big-time playmaker that he used to be in previous seasons. And the fact that he is struggling with a lack of receiving weapons, even though he has managed to thrive without Davante Adams, for evidence, Aaron Rodgers has a 13-6 record without Adams. And the fact that he is struggling to make plays despite having a subpar receiving core goes to show you how much of a disappointment Aaron Rodgers has been. Aaron Jones is having a better season than the previous season, all because he has to carry the load more due to how much the Packers offense has been struggling, but his production is still not enough for the Packers to win games. And looking at the defense, they have been far from being one of the elite defenses in the league. And honestly, the Packers defense is overrated. I know there were injuries from Rashawn Gary and Devondre Campbell, two major key players for the Packers defense that affected their defense, but when they were playing, the defense were among the top 10, but they are far from being the best defense in the league, like we projected them to be before the season started. Jair Alexander, despite his superb performance against CeeDee Lamb in the Cowboys game, he hasn't been the second best corner in the game like he used to be in previous seasons. And it's evident against Terry McLaurin in that Commanders game, where he allowed 4 catches for 67 yards, and against the Giants, where he allowed 4 targets for 44 yards, with 25 yards coming after the catch. In that game, Alexander didn't have a horrible game, but he allowed a 112.5 opponent rating in that game based on PFF. Overall, Alexander has taken a step back coverage wise, although he's still among the 10 best cornerbacks in the game, but he is no longer the second best cornerback in terms of where you rank him in the top 10 players at his position. Their run defense has been a huge problem for this defense, especially with the absence of Devondre Campbell. And after that Titans game, there are more problems on defense than just their run defense. Overall, the Packers have been a huge letdown this season and deserve to be mentioned in my list. The Los Angeles Rams has been absolutely anus all year. They have a 3-6 record, last in the NFC West division. Matthew Stafford has been anus despite their horrible offensive line. Stafford has been making very questionable decisions with the football, especially at times where he will be throwing clear double coverages. He has clearly lost a step in his play, and that contract that he signed last offseason is looking pretty suspect if you're asking me. Allen Robinson has been a huge letdown for me. He's clearly not the same guy that he was back with the Chicago Bears. He hasn't had one game where he had over 8 receptions for over 100 receiving yards. His best game is where he had 5 receptions for 64 yards. I mean, Allen Robinson is just a shell of his former self, and he's clearly one of the most disappointing players so far this season. Cooper Kupp is the reason why the Rams are not bottom 3 offensively and literally carrying the load on offense. But like I said, football is a team game, and one guy is not going to will a team to a championship by themselves. And also, Cooper Kupp is out due to injury, so the offense is definitely going to suffer more without him. Sean McVay, as a head coach, has been making more emotional and aggressive decisions with his play calling, and is certainly affecting the Rams' offense. Rams' defense has taken a step back. Although Aaron Donald is Aaron Donald, Bobby Wagner is still among one of the better linebackers in the league, but it's clear that he lost a step due to age. Jalen Ramsey throughout this season is no longer the best cornerback in the game due to him getting burnt more often and also busting more coverages. He is still an elite cornerback, but this season alone, he is no longer the best at his position. While the defense is not bad, but they haven't been enough to carry this team to wins. So far, the Rams has been one of the biggest disappointments in the NFL and rightly deserves to be in my list. I think we all agree that JC Jackson has one of the worst contracts in the league. For those who do not know, Jackson signed a 5-year, $82 million deal last offseason, and in the games he's played in, he was dog shit. He allowed 256 total yards. Quarterbacks were 13 of 19 when targeting Jackson. He has a 35.7 defensive grade, which ranks him 105th among quarterbacks and allowed 2 touchdowns. Through 6 games, the man was actually benched in overtime against the Broncos in Week 5. That's how shit he has been throughout this season. Although he is out for the remainder of the season due to an Achilles tear, but either way, Jackson has been one of the biggest disappointments and the reason for the Chargers' struggles on defense. And looking back on last offseason, I was shocked of how Bill Belichick let JC Jackson go in free agency. But now it seems that Belichick made the right decision, because this season further proves my point of why JC Jackson is a product of Bill Belichick's system, making defensive players better than they actually are. Hopefully, he'll pick up his play going to next season, because if he doesn't, then the front office really needs to consider whether to get rid of him in order to free up some cap space. There are many big disappointments that I've talked about in this video, but if y'all say that the Las Vegas Raiders has been the biggest disappointment this season, I will not be mad at you, because my God, the Raiders has been anus! Currently, they have a 2-7 record and are last in the AFC West. On offense, they have given up multiple 17 or more point leads. The offense looked stale, and the only dynamic playmakers on offense are Davante Adams and Josh Jacobs. The O-line has been below average, and overall, the offense has been a huge fucking letdown. Although the Raiders lost guys like Darren Waller and Hunter Renfrow due to injuries, well, Renfrow hasn't contributed that much for the team in 6 games, but even with both of them on the field, this team was still choking leads. Josh McDaniels, as the head coach, is now already in the hot seat in just his first year. Raiders fans begged the front office to fire this man. But all honesty, guys, I will give him one more year to prove himself, because it's his first year as head coach. But if next year, if the Raiders, for instance, have an 0-4 start, then yeah, McDaniels will be out of the job. And let me say this to Derek Carr. Derek Carr will always be an average to above average quarterback at best. And signing him to a 3-year, $121 million deal is way too much money for a player in his caliber. I don't think that he can put his team on his back like a Patrick Mahomes or a Josh Allen, Lamar Jackson, or even guys like Deshaun Watson, for instance. It's only a matter of time before the Raiders must decide whether to move on from Derek Carr. Carr, similar to Andy Dalton, hasn't won a playoff game throughout his career, and although he should have had 2 playoff appearances in his resume, because in the 2016 season, Carr had his best season of his career, he was 3rd in MVP voting and led the Raiders to a 12-4 record, but he didn't play in the wildcard game because he fractured his tibia in the last regular season game of that year. But his first playoff appearance, he wasn't horrible, but his performance wasn't so good to the point that it was memorable. And throughout his career, he did have seasons where he was inconsistent. And I don't think that you can win a Super Bowl with Derek Carr as your quarterback. And like I said, it's only a matter of time before he's replaced. Moving on to the defense, Max Crosby is the reason the Raiders' defense are not the worst in the league, because despite his production, the Raiders' defense has been dog shit. They haven't finished in the top 16 in scoring defense since 2002. There are 26 in scoring defense, 26 in third down defense, and most importantly in the red zone, they are almost dead last in red zone defense. Just watching the games and doing research, the Raiders defense has been heinous. They couldn't tackle nor cover anybody. Chandler Jones has been shockingly bad through 9 games. I mean, this man only recorded half a sack. Yes. Half a sack in those 9 games. Like, how does that even happen? Just watching the games alone, he is easily one of the most disappointing players in the league. I can go on and on about the Raiders, but I think that's enough because I don't want to make this video too long, so I'm just going to leave it as that. And the biggest disappointment so far this season is none other than Russell Wilson. Looking back a few years from now, I think we all agreed that the Broncos may have made one of the worst trades in NFL history, because the fact that they sent the largest amount of assets in exchange for a quarterback like Russ is mind-boggling to say the least. First and foremost, the 5th round pick of this year's draft, in which the Seahawks selected Tariq Woolen. And right now, he's looking like he can be among the 5 best cornerbacks in the league in a few years. In the first round, they selected Charles Cross, and so far, he has been a rock-solid rookie tackle for the Seahawks. What the Seahawks are doing this season is shocking everyone in the league, and right now, the future is looking bright. I'm not going to go too much in detail because this is a disappointment video, but the most shocking thing about the Seahawks is that Geno Smith, who was a backup to Russell Wilson last year, is now outplaying him and leading the Seahawks to a 6-4 record. That tells you a whole lot of how shitty Russell Wilson has been. Let me show you some stats here, guys. In PFF, through the first 5 weeks, Wilson was ranked 26th in the league among 32 starting quarterbacks with a 59.7 grade. And sure, the grade for Russell Wilson may have changed since then, but his shitty play didn't change so much. He hasn't been making the throws that he usually makes last season, and also he is scared to complete a pass near the goal line. Wilson is the biggest reason why the Broncos are struggling on offense, and the fact that they signed this man on a 5-year, $245 million deal just after trading for his ass, not only his contract is going to take up so much cap space, but even if the Broncos were to trade him, no team in the league is going to take on his contract. So the Broncos are in a very messy situation with Russell Wilson. And so far, Russ has been by far the biggest disappointment. Thank y'all for watching the vid. What are y'all's thoughts on this video? Is it an accurate list or not? Let me know in the comment section below, and make sure y'all subscribe for more NBA and NFL content in the future. Smash the like button. It will help my channel a whole lot. Turn on post notifications, and that is all. Stay litty. This is the A-Man Show, sign out.